plastic is fantastic, but not everyone agrees. Unfairly, plastic that is derived from a waste product of oil refining has a bad name. Few people appreciate or understand that every barrel of crude oil extracted contains a cocktail of materials, all suitable for different applications, from bitumen to aviation fuel. Naphtha is the material that forms the basis of all the plastics around us. Yet it is on average only 3% of all oil extracted. It is a byproduct and would otherwise be flared off, burnt and wasted. The plastic packaging derived from naphtha has many properties. Just look at the comparison of energy utilized to manufacture water piping. Consider the difference in weight and energy costs between glass bottles and plastic bottles. The diverse properties of plastic allow it to be used for a multitude of packaging products. Heat sealable. Rapid wrapping machines rely on heat sealing. Food safe. Plastic is aseptic and direct food contact is not a problem. Printability. Point of sale performance is brilliant with excellent print qualities. Barrier. Odors and freshness can be contained, moisture kept out. Shrinkability. Heat shrinkage protects fragile or perishable items. Lightweight. Strong and thin, using minimal resources. Impervious. Most acids and many solvents are safely contained. High clarity. Foods and non-foods benefit from point-of-sale display. Functionality. Durable and moldable for a multitude of products. Rigidity. Stiff and resilient to protect fragile items. Those useful properties just described mean that disposing of plastics is a problem. The molecular structure resists oxidation and decomposition. Being lightweight, robust, and often highly colored or printed, plastic waste is highly visible. Wildlife will often fall foul of it. There is a simple solution. If plastic packaging contained the small addition of D2W, oxo-biodegradable additive, then the problem literally disappears. How can this be? To understand how, first take a look inside a plastic packaging material. It is made up of millions of chains of molecules, all entangled, binding it together and providing its strength and properties. These chains are composed of hydrogen and carbon atoms bonded together. At the appropriate time, the D2W within the material starts to cut these chains and generate free radicals. This is an intermediate reaction that results in the creation of new compounds from the existing material blending with the oxygen from the atmosphere. It is these aldehydes, esters, alcohols, ketones and carboxylic acids that are consumed by microorganisms, bacteria and fungi and plants. What started out as a plastic material has now descended to a low molar mass material,